Mike Zimmer's terrible coaching allows the Steelers to make this comeback, and they're down to like 20 seconds, and they get a first down, and Chase Claypool celebrating like, you know, I mean, geez, what is this guy, a child? You're a professional. You're celebrating a first down. It cost his team another play. They might have had another play to run out there. Honestly, Chase Claypool, this team is so undisciplined. Mike Tomlin's horrible. Mike Zimmer, if you're the Vikings, I'd fire him immediately following this game. You're up 29 to nothing. They score a touchdown. 3 minutes left in the third quarter. You come out throwing the ball. All you got to do is you're Dalvin Cook. He's averaging 9.9 yards a carry. You run the ball, take it into the fourth quarter, because that's what you're going to do. And then you punt it, whatever. Or you score it, whatever. You don't throw the ball there. You let him back in the game. And then you threw the ball again when you shouldn't have. And he had an interception, almost returned for a touchdown. Mike Zimmer's horrible. There's a reason the Vikings are in every game. It comes down to the wire. It's coaching. He's a bad coach. He's been there, what, 8 years? It's time for him to go. And I'm not even a Vikings fan, but I see a lot of Kevin Stefanski's garbage-ass coaching in Mike Zimmer. I would definitely fire Zimmer. This Vikings team's actually a good team. But Zimmer's holding them back because that game was over. And the Steelers almost came back and won it or tied it. But it shouldn't have been that close. I mean, it should have been, honestly, the final score should have been something like 36-10. 36-14 at worst. But Mike Zimmer let him back in the game with this horrible. I mean, he's passing when he should be running. He's just terrible. And I read somewhere where the Vikings, every game comes down to a last possession. He's the reason why. Whoever the owner is there, fire the clown and get somebody else because this team, it should not have been that close. And Roethlisberger actually looked good late in the game, didn't he? He was making some throws out there. Now, I will say this, throwing the ball up in there. His receivers were winning them 50-50 battles and making miraculous catches. So I don't want Steeler fans to be like, oh, Ben's back. No, he looked good in these 50-50 balls, just throwing it up in the air. But trust me, Ben Roethlisberger's not back. But he did look good in the fourth quarter. I'll give him that. But he got bailed out a lot by his receivers. But it was a good game. The last quarter, I should say. And the Steelers, they're just so bad. It's like, the other team makes mistakes to give them chance to get back in the game, and they capitalize on it. They do. They capitalize on it for some fucked up reason. First half, they had like 25 yards, and they come back and capitalized on it. Basically, their season's over. They're 6-6-1 now. That tie really cost them, and their schedule's brutal. I don't give them a shot at the playoffs. I don't even think Steelers fans do. Roethlisberger did look good in the fourth quarter, but that was because Mike Zimmer is a dumbass. Fire Mike Zimmer. Kirk Cousins played like shit tonight. He played terrible. Made a good throw to increase the lead to 30. And I thought they should have went for two when it was 35 to whatever. Because they could have won up 17-3 scores. But they were up two scores. But whatever. I don't give a fuck. The bottom line is this. Claypool, you celebrated when you don't know football, son. And if Tomlin has no control over that team. It's time for Tomlin to move on also. And if you people think that Aaron Rodgers or Russell Wilson is going to come to Pittsburgh. Did you see the dress Ben Roethlisberger's on there all first half? He ain't coming. No one's coming to that team. Let me go play football in the Midwest in my golden years. Get the fuck out of here. So get used to it, Pittsburgh. Your seasons are going to look an awful lot like the Cleveland Browns seasons of old. You know it as well as I do, too. It's the truth. Deal with it.